Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam played a very important role in the knowledge that we have. The knowledge of the Ahlulbayt, most of it was delivered through Imam al-Baqir and his son Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam. Because it was during the lives of Imam al-Baqir and Imam al-Sadiq that the Ahlulbayt, they found a window of opportunity to spread the knowledge. Because you see, the father of Imam al-Baqir, Imam Zaynul-Abidin, his only way, one of his only ways of spreading the knowledge was through dua, crying for Imam al-Husayn. Because of the political circumstances and the political situation, Imam Zaynul-Abidin didn't have the opportunity. And it was during the era of Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, which his imamah lasted for 18 years after the death of his father. During these 18 years, there were five of the caliphs of Bani Umayyah that came to power and they died. So they did not have the opportunity to hold on to power very strongly. So you see that it was during that time, the Imam had the opportunity to teach people. Many that would gather around the Imam in the Masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and the Imam would teach them. The Imam would say, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله, and then he would say the hadith. He would mention the ahadith of Rasulullah, the ahadith of the Ahlul Bayt, the ahadith of his fathers. And this is how today we have received the knowledge of the Ahlul Bayt, through Imam al-Baqir and Imam al-Sadiq. There were several companions of Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam who today we are indebted to these companions. Because it was these companions who took the knowledge of Imam al-Baqir and Imam al-Sadiq and they delivered it to us. Today, if you open the books of hadith, you will find the names of these companions. One of them is a man by the name of Jabir ibn Yazid al-Ju'fi. This companion of Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, he had memorized 70,000 hadith from Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam. Now, if the companion memorizes 70,000 hadith, imagine how much knowledge does his teacher have, Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam. This man, Jabir ibn Yazid al-Ju'fi, he was such a close companion that the circumstances at the time called for him to go insane. He acted as if he is insane for a short while during his life to preserve his own life. Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, he sends him a letter with the letter Jim written on it. He took that letter and he understood from that letter that he has to act as a majnoon. He has to act as if he's an insane person. So this man, and imagine how difficult it is. He's a faqih, a man who has memorized over 70,000 ahadith. He would go out in the streets and he would act as if he's insane. And the children would run after him. A while later, Hisham ibn Abdul Malik, the Khalifa, he writes a letter to his governor in Medina. He tells him, arrest Jabir ibn Yazid al-Ju'fi. So the governor, he goes to arrest Jabir. He sees Jabir is insane. So then he leaves him. He does not arrest him. And then he writes a letter back to Hisham ibn Abdul Malik, telling him, this man is insane. Why do you want me to arrest him? So he leaves him. Then the Imam, he writes him a letter. Once the danger is removed, he tells him, go back to how you were. So he would go and sit in the masjid and he would say, حدثني وصي الأوصياء ووارث علم الأنبياء محمد بن علي. The inheritor of the knowledge of the prophets and the inheritor of the awsiya, Muhammad ibn Ali al-Baqir, told me. And then he would say the hadith and he would educate people. Now, just by mentioning the story, we are able to comprehend the difficult circumstances that our imams lived in. The imam has so much knowledge, but the imam is limited because of society. Because of how society is harassing the imam and harassing the companions of the imams alayhim salam. Imam al-Baqir alayhim salam, nonetheless, he kept spreading the knowledge of the Ahlul Bayt. He kept spreading the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. One day, on a hot day, the imam, he is out in his farm. He has a farm and he is working, the imam. During the daytime, and it was very hot, one of the persons there, he says that I saw the Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, he is sweating so much and he is working. So I said to myself, this is my opportunity to come and tell him what you're doing is wrong. Work for this dunya, to strive and struggle so much. Go and rest, it's hot. You're the grandson of Rasulullah. So he comes to the Imam and he tells him, what would you answer Allah if you were to die in this state? And you died because you are working in seeking this dunya, seeking this life. The Imam alayhi salam, he replied, he says, if I died doing anything else, what would I answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Right now, if I died in this state, I would have died in a state of ibadah, in a state of worship, because I'm seeking a halal sustenance. I'm preserving my family, I'm preserving my sustenance, I'm working for a sustenance, for something halal for me to take. What's wrong with that? And this is how the Imam teaches his companions and teaches people around him. In another event, one day a man, he came and he called the Imam Baqara. The Imam is al-Baqir. He came and he called him Baqara. He cow, Baqara. The Imam alayhi salam, he did not reply in a negative way, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنَ السَّيِّئَةِ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. Repel evil with good. The Imam said, if I have done anything wrong, then I ask Allah to forgive me. And if you have done anything wrong, then I ask Allah to forgive you. That man, right away he was struck. He is trying to humiliate the Imam. But the Imam replied in that way. Hisham ibn Abd al-Malik, the Caliph, he called Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam all the way to Sham. He wanted to harass the Imam. He made the Imam leave Medina and come all the way to Sham. Imam al-Baqir came with his son, Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam. They came together. Hisham, he did not allow Imam al-Baqir and Imam al-Sadiq to sit. He kept them standing outside. And then after several hours, he tells them, come, but he doesn't allow them to sit. During that time, there were several generals of the army of Hisham ibn Abd al-Malik that were shooting arrows. They were shooting arrows on the target, archery. Hisham ibn Abd al-Malik, he wants to humiliate the Imam. He wants to see, let me catch him in something that he doesn't know how to do. He tells him, oh Muhammad, I want you to shoot an arrow. I want you to shoot at the target. Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, he tells him, I've grown old and this is not something that I've grown doing. He tells him, no, you have to shoot. So Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, he takes an arrow, he pulls the string and he shoots it and it goes right in the middle of the target. And then he tells him, shoot another one. And then he shoots a third and a fourth until 9 arrows and they all hit the target. And then Hisham, he tells him, you said you didn't know. How is it that you shot all of them and you were able to hit all of them? The Imam tells him, this is the kamal. This is the completeness that we have inherited from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. This is what the imama is. Where we inherit everything. We are complete in everything that we do. So then Hisham, he tells him, can your son Ja'far, referring to Imam al-Sadiq, can he also do the same thing? Imam al-Baqir tells him, yes, he could also do the same thing. This is something that we inherited from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. This is something that Allah has given us. And he recited these verses from the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. He recited to him that this is a position, the position of imama is not just a normal position. Not anyone could come and say, I'm an imam. You have to be appointed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to receive that guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The majlis, there were many of the generals and the people of Sham, they were sitting there. Hisham, he realized that if the Imam, he stays here any longer, he will not have any followers. He will not have anyone to follow him in Sham. Right away, he tells the Imam, go back to Medina. Don't stay in Damascus. So the Imam, he left. Hisham did not want him to stay there and spread his knowledge. As the Imam was going back, he saw that there were a group of Christians that were gathered in an area on their way back to Medina. They asked, what's going on? Why is everyone gathering here? They replied that there's a scholar, there's an alim that will come out. He comes out once a year, and this alim, he comes and he teaches people, he educates people. So everyone is waiting for this alim to come, the Christian scholar. So Imam al-Baqir and Imam al-Sadiq, they also stood there. Once he came out, the Christian man, he saw Imam al-Baqir and right away he recognized that he was someone who is different. Someone who is not like everyone else. from the way that he looks. So he tells him, who are you? Are you from the Muslims or are you from the Christians? The Imam replied, I am from the Muslims. The man, the scholar, who was a very old man, he said, أنت من علمائهم أم من جهالهم? Are you from their scholars or are you from the ignorant out of the Muslims? The Imam, who is Sayyid al-Ulama, who is the master of the scholars and the teacher of the teachers, the Imam, he replied, لست من جهالها. I am not from the ignorant one. And here, this is some humility that we learn from the Imams of the Ahlulbayt alayhim salam. The Imam who is the most knowledgeable of people. So then the man, he says, let me ask you a few questions. So he asks him a few questions. He says, you Muslims, you say that in paradise, people eat and drink without having to use the restroom. He tells him, show me an example. Show me an example in this life where it happens. So the Imam alayhi salam, he tells him, al-janin fi batni ummah. The embryo, the child in the womb of the mother. Nutrition comes to the child, but the child doesn't have to use the restroom. And this is a legitimate answer that the Imam answered. And then he asked him another question. And then a third question. The Imam alayhi salam, he answered the question. Once the Imam answered the question, that Christian priest, that knowledgeable person, he got very upset and he became very sad that there's someone who's more knowledgeable than him. He says, I'm going to leave since there's someone more knowledgeable than me. And he went back in his cave. And everyone gathered around Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam and they began to ask him questions. This is Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam. This is the knowledge of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam.